weekend, the former featherweight king, the King of Rio, Jose Aldo, looks to take on a surging, come on, Merab! Merab Dvalishvili, the machine, Bert Kreischer's favorite fighter. This should be an interesting fight, Matt, and I absolutely love it because for Merab Dvalishvili, 63 takedowns landed in the UFC, 50 in the bantamweight division. That's an all-time bantamweight record. How wild is that? A division that Henan Barao dominated for the longest time. Dominic Cruz was the GOAT there for the longest time. Merab Dvalishvili getting things done with his takedowns. He loses his first two fights in the UFC, one by split decision to Frankie Saenz, who probably is watching this fight from like an armchair going, boys, I bet you if I laced him up one more time, I could fight Jose Aldo. And he lost on an odd submission to Ricky Simon, a guy who is up there in terms of takedowns landed in the UFC, a guy who looked great against Jack Shore's last time out. For Merab, he's won 7 fights since then, and he got his first finish inside of the UFC against Marlon Moraes, whose left hook Larry landed just about every single time in the first round of their matchup, dropped Merab, ended up on top, hammered away. But by the end of that first round, Merab was hammer-fisting away to poor old Marlon's face, and at the start of the second round, it was more of the same. Merab looked great in his last fight, and he's looked very, very good in these 7 fights, and I think his best fight might have even been the Cody Stamann fight, where he completely blew the doors off of a great, great wrestler. 2019 Sambo, what was he, silver medalist at the 68kg mark. Merab is still of that ilk, still lacing him up, still getting it done with Sambo, with his grappling. He is not just a one-dimensional guy, because he will throw those looping shots, he will throw a little bit of a jab, and he loves to go full helicopter on spin attacks like he did against Ralphie on Stotts to earn the Ring of Combat bantamweight belt.
And pretty great win in hindsight.
If you know anything about Ralphie, he's that hottest prospect or champion at this point over with Bellator. Merab has a great opportunity to face off against a legend like Jose Aldo, who for a time looked like all was lost. Now he's on a tidy little 3-fight win streak. The last 2 fights, he's looked absolutely amazing. And while Rob Font in their last fight outlanded him in terms of significant strikes, in terms of total strikes, Jose Aldo had something that figures more into the overall scoring criteria. 2 judges had it 50-45, Aldo, 1 had it 49-46. He was like Darren Elkins. He put the damage on him. And it really was the damage against Rob Font that won Jose Aldo that fight.
He lit him up in that fight. And he looked good from round 1 to round 5, which has always been a question mark for Aldo really throughout his career. Even when he was the GOAT at 145, he would get tired as fights went on. And then down at 135 pounds, he didn't really know how his body was going to react. But I really liked the pace that he was able to push in that matchup. But we have seen Jose Aldo do something in 2 fights down at this weight class later on into fights. He did it against Marlon Vera, where he won that fight, wrestled near the end of that. He did the same thing against Rob Font in their matchup later on in that fight. So I'm curious to see if he does fight Merab Dvalishvili, and if he does start to feel the effects of the wrestling, would Jose Aldo consider taking a guy like Merab down? Because I think that's where he could get into some trouble in this matchup. If he does try to invite the grappling whatsoever with Dvalishvili, it's going to just completely get rid of the one weapon that he will be able to beat Merab with, and that's his striking. Jose Aldo at 135 is one of those heavy-handed strikers in the division. He might not always get the knockout, but he can get multiple knockdowns. And against Merab, who definitely struggled against the power of Marlon Moraes in their last fight, like, he looked like he was completely out. He was off, or completely out of it, on his feet, stumbling all over the place. Now, he is in phenomenal shape, has great cardio, and those 2 things do help you recover from really scary situations like that. But if Jose Aldo is able to land the similar shots that Marlon was able to, I think Jose Aldo has a much more sustainable game plan than Marlon does, and I think he has a lot better takedown defense. The difference is, Jose Aldo at this stage of his career, you're still kind of wondering, okay, when is he going to fall off a peak? He might not necessarily be prime Jose Aldo anymore. I don't think I'd get much of an argument if I said that, but he is still a very good version of himself. He kind of went from MVP caliber to all NBA. Like, he still stands out amongst all-stars and amongst ranked fighters. But at a certain point, we are going to see Jose Aldo's cardio fall off a cliff. We are going to see some of that power get diminished. And I'm worried that against a guy like Merab, who can force his cardio on you, he makes it more of a cardio contest than a mixed martial arts fight. Is that going to just sort of wear on Jose Aldo enough and create enough non-separation between these 2 guys to where Aldo won't be able to land any of his own power shots? But he does have some of the best takedown defense we've ever seen in the UFC. Like, I always go back to Chad Mendes in his prime, where he'd get, like, completely in on the hips of Jose Aldo, and Aldo would be able to scramble, sprawl, do whatever he could to break the grips of any of his opponents. So this fight's going to be amazing no matter who wins.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at it for Jose Aldo, 90% takedown defense, UFC, WEC.
And against good wrestlers, too.
Very good wrestlers. And for Aldo, you've seen a little bit of a progression in his game where he's moved over to boxing much more in his fights, gotten away from the leg kick a little bit. And in the Ricardo Lamas fight, I go back, he had 20 leg kicks in that fight. All 20 counted. They really did. And if you look at it for Jose Aldo, you look at it, the fight against Marlon Vera, 6. They were early, they counted, and then they opened up his boxing. Against Pedro Munoz, he landed 8. Now, Pedro landed a ton of them, but that's the biggest part of his game.
He landed a lot on Piotr Jan, even though he lost that fight.
And against Rob Font, he was able to land 10, but it really did open up his boxing, open up his good right hand, his quick left hook. And that's the best part about Jose Aldo. Once he starts getting you up top, that gets him into an opportunity where he can rip to the body, really slow those energy systems. And from there, it's just that snowball effect of Aldo's game. From Merab, herky-jerky striking, back and forth, eats a ton of leg kicks. He even did in his fight against Marlon Moraes. But he just goes back to the wall with his takedowns. And even if you pop back up, you pop up, he still has his hands locked around the seatbelt position. And then he gets you back down to the mat. So very, very fun right there out of both these guys. Very much clash of styles. Will Jose Aldo be able to keep up his pace? Because there were always questions. I mean, from 2015 to the summer of 2020, he went 3-6. And then since then, he rips off these three
best fighters in the
wins.
World, though.
He did. I mean, Max Holloway a couple times. Conor McGregor, obviously, had the fight against Piotr Jan.
Volkanovski.
Alexander Volkanovski. The split decision loss to Marlon Moraes, which up in the air, who won, who didn't. Both of these guys, opposite ends of the spectrum. MMA Mass says Merab wins. And somebody threw it in the comment section this week. Craig, you should do MMA math more often. You were right when you did it for Nate Landwehr against David Onama. You should do it. No, that's not how this works. Even though you have a bad week, you dance with the girl that you brought. You keep doing what you were doing. When you look at this fight, Matt, Jose Aldo open a minus 170 favorite, minus 103 right now. For Merab, open the underdog, plus 145, minus 120. And if we have a look at the Tapology votes, Matt, surprise us there to you. Honestly, I don't know where they're going to be at all. I'm going to say over under 60% Merab.
I'll say under.
I'm going to say under. Yeah, so 881 total votes, 72% Jose Aldo, 74% by decision, 21% by knockout. For the 28% that have Merab to win, 85% by decision, 8% by knockout. So Matt, the odds have shifted towards Merab. The fans have Jose Aldo to get the win. That's always a fun wrinkle in this one. You think Merab's going to be able to just put a pace on him for three rounds? Because it is only a three-round fight. You think he's going to be able to outpace him and just grind out a decision?
It doesn't happen often, and I can't think of many examples, but it has happened a rare few occasions where you have a sweep in a playoff series, but it's a close sweep. Like, the team loses 2 points, and that'll just be it. Like, the margin of victory is like 1.5 points. All the games were close, even though the person got swept. I think that's how this fight's going to go. You can make an argument for either guy absolutely mollywhopping the other in the first round, and it not be competitive whatsoever, but the fact that you can make such a strong argument for both guys is what makes this fight so much fun. I'm ever so slightly going to pick Merab Dvalishvili, even though I can fully admit that things can go very poorly for him 5 seconds into this matchup. The difference is, Merab has shown the ability to fight through some very poor instances. Even his loss to Ricky Simone, he got choked out in the strangest way possible. It was like he saw a ghost.
Keep kicking. Keep kicking.
Was he out? I'm not a doctor. Maybe he was. I don't know. It was really weird, though. But Merab, he got that dog in him. And if things do go poorly for him in the first 5 seconds, I think he can fight through some of those areas. Whereas with Jose Aldo, I think he's going to need that early success to really win this fight, because Merab Dvalishvili's wrestling does feel inevitable for a lot of guys at this division. And I know Aldo has some all-time great takedown defense, but Merab Dvalishvili has some all-time great takedown offense. So that's why I think this fight's going to be so much fun. You sort of have two greats in their own areas going to battle and going to show who's better in that one situation. So I like Merab Dvalishvili, but I am very open to a world where Jose Aldo looks phenomenal.
Merab lands 7.3 takedowns per 15 minutes. It's insane. Most takedowns in UFC bantamweight history for Merab. Jose Aldo has a really great left hand, really good boxing, really good takedown defense. I think he knocks Merab out in the first round. I mean, this feels to me like one of those fights where I went with Jack Hermanson and it was totally against all of the fans that were out there and it felt really silly, and he was able to outpoint in that matchup. For me, I look at this fight as Merab has great takedowns. He has wonky striking that opens up some of his takedowns, but once he gets one, he stops striking, and then it's just all takedowns. And I'm eager to see what we get out of Merab when, if when and if Jose Aldo is able to defend some takedowns. I love Jose Aldo's striking. I think he can get it done here against Merab. Merab's one of those tricky guys, though. You can still kick his lead leg as hard as you want. Kick it like a mule if you want. And he'll continues
fall down
to go
and
forward.
Turn it into a wrestling exchange. Yeah. That's why I like Merab in this. Again, Jose Aldo, I think, can have a really good first 7 minutes, but then I worry about him after that. Whereas Merab, I kind of worry about him for the first 7 minutes, and then I become more confident in him. I think you can make a very strong case for either one of these guys fighting. That's why the odds are so close, and that's why this could quite possibly even be a title eliminator. Like, I know the bantamweight division has a lot of very exciting names, a lot of very popular names, and they can make a lot of exciting fights in the future. And the good thing is, a lot of these guys are matched up right now, so we are going to get some sort of closure to this division and the title picture sooner rather than later, but I'm really excited for this fight. I think it's going to be an incredible one.
The winner fights Marlon Vera. Matt has Merab to get the win. I'm going with the King of Rio, Jose Aldo, to get it done. Let us know down below in the comments section who you have. It's going to be a contentious fight. There's going to be plenty of comments of flying, so make sure you get yours down there. We have a big time co-main event between the Eraser Paulo Costa and Luke Rockhold. Male model. And in the main event, Kamaru Usman taking on Leon Edwards, the rematch. So you're going to want to keep it locked in with Fight Night Picks. We always say, let's get into it.